אני אומרת לכם ירושלים, מה עובר לכם בראש? מה זה ירושלים? בית המקדש.
כותל.
מי מאמין שבית המקדש ייבנה בשנים הקרובות? מה יש שם עכשיו על בית המקדש? אז מה יקרה מהמסגד?
Basically, what's happening here is that she's trying to plant in their minds there's going to be some kind of destruction of Al-Aqsa Mosque and replacement to the temple.
Masjid Aqsa.
Beytul Makdis, Beytul Mukaddes. 17 kadar farklı adı var hünkârım.
Evet. Lakin Siyonistler Sarı Kubbeli Kubbetü Sahra'yı Mescid-i Aksa diye basıyorlar gazetelerde.
Niçin hünkârım?
Çünkü Mescid-i Aksa'nın altında Süleyman Mabedi'nin olduğuna inanıyorlar. Bir gün Mescid-i Aksa'yı yıksalar, Sarı Kubbeli Kubbetü Sahra ayakta kalsa, işte bakınız, Mescid-i Aksa ayakta diyecekler.
Çok sesli bir tertip hünkâr.
Aynen öyle. Zihnimizle oynuyorlar. Mescid-i Aksa içinde Kıble Mescidi'nin ve Kubbetü Sahra'nın bulunduğu genişçe bir alan. Mescid-i Aksa'nın altında Süleyman Mabedi'nin kalıntıları olduğuna ve onu yeniden inşa edeceklerine inanıyorlar. Sarı Kubbeli Kubbetü Sahra'yı Mescid-i Aksa gibi gösterip etrafında her türlü işi yapmayı tertipliyorlar.
Hünkârım, bu oyunu anlatmak şart.
Sizi de bunun için çağırdım İsmail Hakkı Bey. Bu hususta bir yazı kaleme alacaksınız. Tercüme odasında her türlü dile çevrilecek ve gazetelerde neşredilecek.
If any of you believe that the Israelis are gonna stop and not take Masjid al-Aqsa, you're deluded. 70 years history has shown us that they've literally wiped out the entirety of Palestine.
He said, what did you say? Tawbah for the qatil, for the murderer? I heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say that the one who was murdered will be resurrected headless. He will be carrying his head in his own hands. The blood is going to be pouring out, dumping out. And he will raise his head to Allah and say, oh Allah, so-and-so kill me. Oh Allah, so-and-so kill me. And he will proceed until he reaches the throne of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah Azza wa Jal will respond to him.
One of the prime ministers said in parliament, how can we defeat a people? When they look down our barrels, they see the gates of paradise. How do we defeat those people?
You said that you scared God all the world? Yes. We scare you, and all the world is better than you. All the world are with us, not with you.
If Ibrahim will be through and your group resists without a wheelchair, 10-year challenge, tell Reagan we are still here. And tell me, until that killer Netanyahu, he should feel fear. The old live through us and guarantee the children will care. Criminal, not invincible and you know it. Sarmadun, still sitting in their stoic. You may not feel us with you when you listen to our poems, but you inspire humanity. Your resistance is heroic. This is for Palestine, Ramallah, West Bank, Gaza. This is for the child that is searching for an answer. We shall continue your tears and replace them with laughter. Long live Palestine!
Long live Gaza!
Long live Palestine!
Long live Gaza!
Long live Palestine!
Long live Gaza!
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, obey Allah and obey His Messenger and don't differ amongst you. Don't start fighting amongst you because you will fail. I'll just give you an example. The Ottomans defended for centuries the Muslim lands. But then the Muslims turned on the Ottomans. They started allying with the colonialists who were promising them things, and they went against their brother Muslims. The last attempt at defending Palestine, it'll bring tears to your eyes if you read the Ottoman, what they tried to do to defend Palestine. And we know that Abd al-Hamid would not sell Palestine to pay off all the debts of the Ottomans, because he said, it's not mine to sell. But they were betrayed, and people betrayed them, and now we suffer the consequences of those people's mistakes. Because Allah says, beware of calamities that don't just affect the guilty amongst you, they affect the innocent too. So people inherit the sins of people that went before them. There's things your father does that you end up being disgraced by. And people will treat you badly because of the sins of your father. There's people that are born out of wedlock and they suffer from the sin of their father. They did nothing. That ayah is in the akhirah. You're not going to have any of the calamities or the sins of anybody else in akhirah. But in dunya, no. We bear the sins of other people. We bear the sins of other people. We're suffering today from choices people made 100 years ago, 200 years ago, 300 years ago. We're still suffering. Syria is going to be dealing with this civil war for generations. These things don't go away. So we were given guidance. We were given a covenant. When the covenant is abandoned, calamities happen. The Prophet ﷺ, his sunnah is the wisdom of this book. Do you think the Prophet ﷺ would tell people to strap bombs on them and go blow up people, innocent people? Is there anything in his sunnah that indicates that that would be a methodology that he would use? Because he was in Mecca. He could have had his sahaba go assassinate people. They were brave. Abu Dharr al-Ghifari was a Ghifari. Really, he was an incredibly brave man. Ibn Mas'ud was incredibly brave. These men were lions in battle. He could have said, go kill secretly, go sneak into so-and-so's house. He didn't do that. Why? Because that's not his methodology. What he does is out in the open. He told people exactly what he was going to do, and he did what he was going to do. The Prophet said, don't desire death. The only time he asked for death is fitna. He said, take me to you out without civil strife. And he said that when Allah wants rahmah, this is a sahih hadith, when Allah wants rahmah for an ummah, he allows the Prophet who gives them the message to live to see them accept the message. But when he wants to punish an ummah, the Prophet who gives them the message sees their destruction in his own life. Subhanallah. And so our ummah, he wanted rahmah for this ummah. Allah wanted rahmah for this ummah.